Third lecture, reference and sense. We have mentioned earlier in the first and second lecture that semantics is the study of meaning in language. And we talked about the meaning of words, phrases, sentences, and their reference in the language and the things that they indicate in the real world. Today we are going to talk about reference and sense. Reference and sense are two basic notions in semantics related to words and phrases. Sense refers to the relations inside the language, and reference refers to the relationships between the words in the language and the things outside the world. Now, let's define reference. What is reference? Reference is the relationship between the word in the language and the thing in the outside world. By means of reference, a speaker indicates which thing in the world he is talking about. He is referring to what? Things can be animate, living things, such as humans, animals, plants, microorganisms, like bacteria, viruses, or inanimate, non-living things, such as car, bed, sea, chair, door, etc. Examples. He is my brother. Here we have the pronoun he identifies a person or refers to a person. Tom is in the class. Here we have two referring expressions, Tom and the class. Tom is a proper noun, identifies a person, and in the class, or the class, the noun or phrase, the class, identifies a place. The bird is beautiful. Here, the noun or phrase, the bird, identifies an animal. The car is too expensive. The noun or phrase, the car, identifies an object. So we have different parts of speech refers to things in the real world. The words and phrases in bold are parts of the language. These words in bold, he, Tom, the class, the bird, the car, are parts of the language. We find them in the language. And the things they refer to are parts of the world, and the relationship between them is reference. So, look at this word, circle. The word circle is a word found in the language and refers to this thing in the outside world. Referring expressions. Referring expressions are those expressions used to refer to things in the world. They often include nouns, like proper nouns and common nouns, pronouns, like he, she, it, I, you, they, and longer descriptive noun phrases, like the beautiful Indian girl. Now we move to another subject, which is constant and variable reference. We said that words refer to things in the world. These things can be constant, never change, and the other one is variable. Variable refer to different things. Reference can be constant or variable. In our world, there are things which are always constant in any place and at any time. For example, the sun, the moon, Venus, the earth, Libya, the Red Sea, etc. These nouns refer to things in the world that are constant. They never change. These are expressions which constant with constant reference. They refer to things that are constant and they never change. They always refer to the same things in any place and at any time. That is, if an American or an Indian or a Libyan says the sun, they all refer to the same thing, because the sun is something constant. Variable reference means that there are expressions in our life used to refer to different things. That is, the same expression may refer to many different things. For example, the expression "my car" can refer to as many potential cars in the world. Your car is different from my car. When I say my car, maybe my car is a different type of car and with different color. So my car can be used by different people to refer to the two different car, not the same car. Even it is the same expression, my car, but when I say my car and you say my car and the other one say my car, we refer to different cars. In the language, expressions with variable reference are too many, while expressions with constant reference are less. Now, look at the following diagram. Are the following expressions in bold have constant or variable reference? We have this sentence, he saw Jack. We have he, pronoun, and Jack, proper noun. So he and Jack are variable because he may indicate any person and Jack may refer to any person with the name Jack, because we have so many people with this name. The sun is shining. The sun here is constant because it refers to a constant thing in the world. Note, two referring expressions or more in the same language can have the same referent, that is, refer to the same thing. Consider the following examples. The morning star, the evening star, and Venus. These three expressions refer to the same thing, which is a planet in our galaxy. The President of the United States and Trump. These two expressions refer to the same thing. So, in language, we can find two or more referring expressions refer to the same thing. Note, two referring expressions or more in different languages can have the same referent, that is, they refer to the same thing. Consider the following examples. The moon and Al-Qamar, Jacob and Ya'qub. These two different words in different languages, but they refer to the same thing and they have the same meaning. Expressions can be referring or not referring depending on the context. That is, the same expression may refer to a particular thing or may not refer to a particular thing according to the context in which the speaker uses it. Consider the following word, bird, in the following examples. Look at that beautiful bird on the tree. Here, the speaker is talking about a particular bird on the tree. And the plane in the sky looks no bigger than a bird. In this sentence, the speaker is not talking about a particular bird. He is just mentioning that the plane in the sky looks similar to a bird. So in the first example, the speaker is talking about an animal which is a bird, certain bird on the tree. And in the second sentence, the word bird indicates that the plane in the sky looks like a bird, but it is not a bird. Now we move to the second notion, which is the sense. The sense of an expression is its place in a system of semantic relationship with other expressions in the language. The first of these semantic relationships that we will mention is synonymy, which means sameness of meaning. Now, let's define synonymy. Synonymy means that two expressions have the same meaning. Two expressions, or maybe more, have the same meaning. Let's consider the following examples. For example, lad and boy have the same meaning, almost, nearly have the same meaning, likely, probable, they have the same meaning, and vertical, upright, two words with the same meaning. So, sameness refers to the notion of sameness of meaning, two different words with the same meaning. We can talk about the sense not only of words, but also of longer expressions, such as phrases and sentences. We mentioned that words have meaning and have sense. Also, phrases and sentences have sense. The morning star and the evening star, these two noun phrases have the same meaning or sense. John took off his jacket. John took his jacket off. These two sentences have the same sense. So, words, phrases, and sentences may have the same sense. In many cases, the same word can have more than one sense. For example, the word spring may mean ناب الحلزوني, عين الماء, ربيع. So, in language, we may find different words with different meanings. One sentence can have different senses too. Just like words have different senses, sentences also can have different senses. Let's consider the following example. The chicken is ready to eat. This sentence can be interpreted in two different ways. The first one, this sentence means the chicken is ready to be eaten. That is, the chicken is ready to be eaten. And the second interpretation, the chicken is ready to eat something. The chicken itself is hungry and is ready to eat. The other example, the principal hit the boy with the stick. The principal hit the boy with the stick. This sentence can be interpreted in two different ways. The first interpretation, the principal is carrying a stick and he hit the boy. And the second one, the boy is carrying a stick and the principal hit him maybe with his hand. Reference is the relation between the word in the language and the thing it refers to in the world, while the sense is the relation between the word and surrounding words in the sentence. That is, sense is the relation between the words in the sentence. The referent of an expression is often a thing found in the world. Whereas the sense of an expression is not a thing at all. It is the meaning that you find in the dictionary. Intuitively, it is sometimes useful to think of sense as that part of meaning of an expression that is left over when reference is factored out. It is much easier to say whether or not two expressions have the same sense. The sense of an expression is an abstract thing, but when a person understands fully what is said to him, we can say that he has grasped the sense of the expressions that he had heard. Rule: every expression that has meaning has sense, but not every expression has reference. There are words that have meaning and refer to things, and there are words that have meaning but they do not refer to things. That is, not all the words in the language refer to things. Words like boy, tree, car, cow have meaning and they refer to things in the world. But words like go, good, slowly, if, on, the, o, etc. have meaning but they do not refer to things in the world. So, all the words in the language have meaning, but not all the words in the language have reference or refer to things. Note: every word that has meaning has sense, but not every word that has meaning has reference. That is, not all the words refer to things in the real world. There is something semantically complete about a proposition, as opposed to the sense of a phrase or single word. One might say, roughly, that a proposition corresponds to a complete independent thought. That is, the sense is found in words and phrases, while a proposition is found in the complete sentence. We have defined earlier that a sentence is a group of words joined together grammatically and expresses a complete thought, that is, have a proposition. So, sentences include proposition. Now, let's have a look to this practice. Are the senses of the following expressions propositions? The first one: Johnny has got a new teacher. The first sentence is a complete sentence and it has a proposition. Yes. Two: a new teacher. A new teacher is not a sentence. It is a noun, a phrase, and we can say that this noun, a phrase, has no proposition. No. Johnny is a noun. Also, there is no proposition in Johnny. Johnny has meaning, but it doesn't have proposition. This is the house that Jack built. Yes, this is a complete sentence and it has a proposition. Number five: when I entered the house, this clause is incomplete and there is no proposition in this clause. No, because it is not a complete sentence. But if we complete it, for example, when I entered the house, I saw my father, it will be a complete sentence and it will have proposition. Now, the same sense can be said to belong to expressions in different languages. Just as we mentioned, before, that two different sentences in the same language may have the same proposition and meaning, we can say also that two different expressions in different languages can have the same meaning and the same sense and the same proposition. For example, the English sentence is, I saw a man, and the Arabic sentence, رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا. These two sentences in different languages express the same proposition, the same idea, the same meaning. The two sentences have the same sense if they are perfect translation to each other. Just as one can talk of the same sense in different languages, so one can talk of expressions in different dialects of one language as having the same sense. That is, we can have two different words in two dialects in the same language with the same sense. For example, pavement in British English and sidewalk in American English have the same sense. Now, we mentioned in this lecture two main ideas, sense and reference. And we said that reference indicates things outside the language, and sense indicates the relations inside the language between the words. So reference can be found outside the language, and sense can be found inside the language between the words of the sentence. This is the end of the lecture. Thank you for your listening. وشكرا لقناة ليبيا روح الوطن ومجمع ليبيا الإعلامي على إتاحة هذه الفرصة لنا لاستفادة من هذا الوقت الثمين وإفادة طلبتنا. وشكرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.